Have you seen this device? This may look like a regular circuit breaker, but wait, this is not. This is called as disconnecting circuit breaker or DCB. In this video, we are going to get introduced with what is disconnecting circuit breaker using 3D model. So before we go to the 3D model and understand what is disconnecting circuit breaker, let us first understand why do we need disconnecting circuit breaker and what is a disconnecting circuit breaker. So in simple terms, disconnecting circuit breaker is nothing but the combination of a regular circuit breaker and a disconnector that we have. They have clubbed it as a one device, and that is what they are calling it as disconnecting circuit breaker. But before we go and understand how the construction is, the 3D model, let us talk about why do we need a disconnector circuit breaker, or simply why disconnecting circuit breaker. So during the initial phase of substation, where the circuit breakers were of oil types, oil circuit breaker or air blast circuit breaker, they needed frequent maintenance. And as a result, the substation configuration, the busbar arrangement were made based on this maintenance requirement of circuit breaker. So you will generally find that circuit breaker is surrounded by disconnector on both the ends. From this end and from this end, you'll find disconnector. You can see here it on the screen. This is one disconnector. We have circuit breaker in between, and again, we have the disconnector here. So whenever a regular maintenance needed to be carried out on this circuit breaker, I had to open this disconnector, and then carry out the maintenance on my circuit breaker. Now, during this process, of course, sometimes the supply continuity used to break, right? The supply availability was the topic. But when we talk about today's world, so whatever we talked about was the previous situation. But in today's world, in today's technology, where we have advanced circuit breaker, technology has improved, the maintenance activity on circuit breaker has significantly gone down. Now, circuit breaker that comes, SF6 circuit breakers, they don't need to have maintenance for 15 to 20 years. So definitely, there was a thought that can we combine the disconnector and circuit breaker as a one device, because now these breakers don't need maintenance, regular maintenance. And that's how the idea of disconnecting circuit breakers were born. So as I mentioned, disconnecting circuit breaker are nothing but a combination of a disconnector and a circuit breaker. They have clubbed it as a one device, and they are calling it as a disconnecting circuit breaker. Now let us look at the construction of the disconnecting circuit breaker using the 3D model. Since the disconnecting circuit breaker is a combination of a disconnector and circuit breaker, it will have all the components of both the devices. Now, it looks similar to that of a regular SF6 circuit breaker, but one of the changes that can be noticed by looking at it is the earthing switch that is provided with the circuit breaker, which is needed for disconnector to earth the trap charges. But this integrated earthing switch is not found with a regular breaker. But here you can see a dedicated earthing switches are provided for each phases. The top part of this breaker consists of the interrupter, just like the regular one. But the speciality of this interrupter is that it also satisfies the requirement of an isolating distance when in open condition, basically the disconnector function. Construction wise, there is no major difference here. The contact system remains the same, the main contact and the arcing contact. To achieve the isolating distance, the distance between the contact may be increased or may not be increased depending on the design and the type testing results. The bottom insulator is the support insulator required to maintain the safe clearances. And then we have a support structure and the operating mechanism to operate the breaker. Now, for this breaker, since we are providing integrated earthing switch, to operate that, for sure, we would need a dedicated earthing mechanism as well, which you can see it here. Here, let us have a look how the operation happens. Thank you. Now, these disconnecting circuit breakers can be used in any traditional substation, and they can significantly reduce the space required for the substation. They combine the disconnecting function of a disconnector, and also they performs the circuit breaker operation without any worry, no compromise on the functionality here. These disconnecting circuit breakers are available from 72.5 kV up to 550 kV, and also there is a dedicated IEC standard for that, and that is IEC 62271-102. That is the dedicated IEC standard we have for disconnecting circuit breaker. Now, since we have a basic idea about what is a disconnecting circuit breaker and how it is constructed, let us talk about some of the advantages of disconnecting circuit breaker here. So the first and the most important advantage is reduction in the maintenance activity. Now, when we compare it with the regular disconnector, regular air insulated disconnector, this disconnector needs frequent maintenance. Again, the maintenance interval can vary from 2 years to 6 years, depending upon the user practice and the atmospheric condition in which these disconnectors are installed. So the maintenance interval can vary from 2 years to 6 years. Regularly, you have to carry out the maintenance. But since we are using a disconnecting function inside the breaker itself, inside the SF6 insulated gas, inside the SF6 insulated chamber, we don't have to carry out any frequent maintenance on that. Just like the circuit breaker, these disconnectors will also, the DCB basically, will need not to have any maintenance for 15 to 20 years. So definitely there is a significant reduction in the maintenance activity, which takes us to the second advantage, that is reduction in the substation space requirement. It reduced the substation space significantly. Just to give you one example here, on the left hand side, you can see a traditional substation wherein a circuit breaker and disconnector dedicated devices are used. You can see the total length of it is around 77 meters. And if we replace a circuit breaker and disconnector in this substation with the disconnecting circuit breaker, then you can see the area is reduced to 50 meters. So almost reduction of 40% space that is needed for substation. So that is a very big advantage that this disconnecting circuit breaker offers. The next one is definitely these are the safer than the regular disconnector. Now, the air insulated switch disconnectors that we see regularly, they definitely are not safer when we compare it with a disconnector which is inside this interrupter filled with SF6 gas. Definitely there will be arcing, sparking that happens whenever you open the disconnector, but that is, everything is eliminated using this disconnecting circuit breaker, which is definitely superior when we compare it with the safety aspect. Clear? And the next is, of course, since we are eliminating one dedicated device, that is disconnector, it also needed less civil activities in the substation. So if you use a dedicated disconnector, then definitely you have to build a foundation for that, a civil foundation, and on top of that there will be support structure, and then there will be disconnector. But since we are using a device which is combination of both, it can be fitted on a single foundation. So definitely there will be reduction in the civil activities as well. Clear? Understood? So these were some of the advantages of the disconnecting circuit breaker. I hope after watching this video, you have got an idea about what is the disconnecting circuit breaker, how the construction is, and what are some of the advantages of that. If you found this video helpful, then do comment helpful in the comment section below. In that way, I'll understand these videos are helping you guys. And definitely, do check out the different electrical courses that I have created on courses.theelectricalguy.in. It will be super helpful for you guys, right? So that's all for this video, guys. I'll see you in my next one. But till then, keep watching, keep learning.